of color fitting in the previous class, and some of the examples were discussed. The main important method which we have to do, that is the least square method. And the least square method is directly linked with the normal equations. So you have to find out the fitting of the curve with the method of least square. So let us continue with that. In today's class, we have to fit a second degree equation of this form, y is equal to a plus bx plus cx square to the following data. This is we need to fit. X is given to us and y is given to us. And this is the curve we want to find. This is the equation of a parabola. If you remember, a, b, c are three constants here which we have to find out. Now, the value of x are given to us, that is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. And y is given to us 1, 4, 7 and 15. This is the equation of a parabola, and we must have the sum total of sigma x, that is 6, and the sum total of sigma y is 27. This is the sum total. Now come to the important point, that is the normal equation. First of all, we need to write down the normal equation for the parabola. As I discussed in yesterday's class, I had told you that with the help of equation of parabola, we can find out the normal equation, normal equations by least square method. This is the method of least square. And how to write down normal equation? This is y. So y will be written as sigma of that. A is a simple constant, so this is multiplied with n plus next is x. So this is b sigma x plus the next is c sigma x square. This is the first normal equation. If a three constant we want to find, so we must write down three normal equations. The next equations will be found with the help of this normal equation. Now you will multiply with x. This is a sigma xy. This is now taken as a single constant, and n will not be taken here. This is sigma x. This is sigma x square. This is sigma x cube. This is the next normal equation. We can write down one more. This is sigma x square y. A sigma x square plus b sigma x cube plus c sigma x 4. This is equation number 4. So these are the normal equation for fitting of the curve of the parabola by the method of least square. So let us find out the required values which we have, which we require for solving these equations. So we require, first of all, we require x, y and x square. So you just find out x, y here. This is let us find out xy. Xy is 0 into 1, 0. And the next value will be 4, 14 and 45. That is a sigma xy. And the sigma xy come out to be 63. Next value will be x square. That will be 0. That is 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, and it come out to be 14. And next we require x cubed. X square is multiplied with x. 0, this is 1, this is 8, this is 27. So sigma x cube total, the total sum of this come out to be 36. We require x4, x square square, this is 0, this is 1, this is 16, this is 81. So sigma x4 come out to be 98. And next we require x square y. X square y is 0, 4, 28, and this come out to be 135. And the sum total is 167. Now you can substitute the values in this. And after substituting the values, the equations become, this is 27, equation number 2 I am writing, and n is, this is 4a plus sigma x is 6b plus x square is 14c. This is the new equation. X y is 63 is sigma x, that is 6a plus 14b plus 36c. And the last equation is 167, 14a, 36b, plus 98c. Now these are the three equations which we have to solve for a, b, c. And because these are linear system of equation, and you can simplify for a, b, c. And after simplifying, a come out to be 1.25, b come out to be 0.75, c come out to be 1.25. You can simplify it. These are the values of a, b, c, and with the help of these values you can write down the equation of a parabola. So 1.25, 0.75x, 1.25x square. So this is the best fit. This is the fitting of a parabola. So this is very important. This is the way to find out the equation of parabola by the method of curve fitting, or by method of least square, principle of least square. So principle of least square is related to normal equations actually. And with the help of normal equations, you will be able to find out the required curve, whether the curve is exponential. I also give you the example of this curve. Suppose we have a curve like this, then you can take the log on both sides. This is log a to the base 10 plus b log of x to the base 10. This was also discussed in the last class. This is y equal to capital A plus capital B into x. And with the help of this, you will be able to, because two unknowns we require, a and b, in this equation. So two normal equations we should have. This is n a plus b sigma x. This is first normal equation, and the second normal equation is sigma x y, and this is a sigma x plus b sigma x square. This is second normal equation. So you have to solve for this data value. And so this same question can be taken, this one, same data values, these data values of x and y can be taken for simplifying this curve, for solving this curve. So you have to put the value in this normal equation, x and y. And clearly, y will not be calculated as we have calculated. What is y? But the y is log of small y to the base 10. So you have to take the log of small y. Then that value will be your capital Y. So this is the procedure to find out the curve fitting And in this topic, we have one more a small topic of correlation and regression. This is also in your course, the topic of correlation and regression. This is also very important. Let us start with the correlation. Correlation, directly we have the formula of Carl Pearson, and this is a very important formula of calculating Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation, that is Rxy, and the formula is n sigma xy minus sigma x sigma y, and it is dividing, that is square root n sigma x square minus sigma x whole square, and square root n sigma y square minus sigma y whole square. So you can calculate the value and fill in this formula. This formula is important, and get the coefficient of correlation. This small r is said to be the coefficient of correlation given by Carl Pearson. So the data values are given to us in the question, x and y. X is 1, 3, 5, 7, 8 and 10. This is given to us, and the sum total is 34. Y is 8, 12, 15, 17, 18 and 20. The sum total is come out to be 90. And what we require? We require sigma xy now. So you will multiply x with y. 1 into 8 is 8, 36, that is 75, 119, 144, this is 200. And the sum total is 582. Now we require x square, and we require y square. And the x square is 1, 9, 25, 49, 64, 100. And the sum total is 248. Y square is 64, 144, 225, 289, 325, 400. And the sum total is 1446. Now you just substitute the values. The values, what is n? The number of values. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is 6 into 582 minus sigma x is 34 into 90. In between there is a negative sign. So in the denominator we should have 6 into 248 minus 34 square, and into square root of 6 into 1446 minus 90 square. So what it come out to be, after calculating you will have 0.987. so this is the required coefficient of correlation between the variables x and y. So this is the procedure to calculate the coefficient of correlation. One more formula we have. This is the formula which will be calculated. Let us straight away apply in the question. X is there, y is there. I will tell you the procedure, that is 10, 14, 18, 22, 26, 30, and y is 18, 12, 24, 6, 30 and 36. So six values have been given to us. And this is the formula related to change of scale and change of dimension. So in this case, the formula is u is equal to x minus a over h, d is equal to y minus b over k. Now, what is x? As it is, p is what? That is taken as assumed mean. Assumed mean in the value of x. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So, 18 and 22. Out of this, you can take any value. 22 upon h. H is taken as 4. Because there is a difference of 4. 10 to 14, difference of 4. 14 to 18, difference of 4. 18 to 22, 22 to 26. Each of the term have difference with the preceding term of 4. So, next is y minus, we are taking, that is 24 divided by 6. It is not compulsory to take the direct value. That is, whether you have taken 22, you have to take 6. It is not always. You can take the value which is nearest to the mean value for calculating b. Now, with the help of this, you can calculate u and you can calculate b. How to calculate u? X minus 22 over 4. So, this is 10 minus 22, minus 12 over 4, minus 3. 14 minus 22, minus 8 over 4, minus 2. So, this is the b. And the formula for calculating coefficient of correlation, R UV is N sigma UV minus sigma U sigma V divided by under root N sigma U square minus sigma U whole square N sigma V square minus sigma V whole square. So this is the formula for calculating R Pearson coefficient of correlation in the case of assumed mean. So you can find out the value, and this formula will be applied when there are values of x and y with a bigger numerical value, so that the calculation become easier. That's why we apply this formula of change of scale and change of dimension, and this new formula will be applied. So this was your Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation. We shall do next method tomorrow's class. That is called as a rank correlation. We shall do in the next class. Thank you very much.